Yeah. Oh, hello.
They're just spur pieces. If a thread breaks, then what you do is the weaver reach over, tie that in, and then with the reed hook, pull it through the correct eye and then through the correct dent in the reed.
Just pull it in and then connect it up
that way. Again, that's why there's always, you'll see it on every loom, it's always first. And also it's the correct one because it's been actually cut off that bead. That's where it'll start feeding from and it'll work that way. It's just a save, that's why I'll pull a bit off. It's if you put it in and it broke, then it's time wasted. No, it depends what you're weaving. I mean, this, because these are original, these three are originals here. They're exactly the same as what you see in the weaving shed, Lancashire looms. They only have two makes, and that was Pemberton with the open book motif on the top, or Harlingen top, which has got the crescent. But they're virtually identical. A lot of the parts are interchangeable, but more important is they all use the same size shuttle. Therefore, the same size perm, so it kept everything uniform. Running on this here, my material, said around about 90 seconds, said as a good indication. The maximum you could run is 6 loops. That'd only give you 15 seconds at each loop. And in that 15 seconds, you could stop it, take the shuttle out. You'd always have another shuttle sat there, or in the loading. Put that in and get your loom going. Then, take an empty burn out, put a new one in, set it down, move on to this one, because this one's ready for running out. Do the same, move on to number 3, and then number 4, number 5, number 6, back to number 1. Pass through. Now, there's thread there, just enough to lift that forward. Now, this hammer shape here, that's on a cap going back, rocking back every time to this side. If there's no wet, it either runs out or it breaks. That stays down. Stops it. Not to rely on that because not to change the burn because it's going to run out a lot of time. It will end up more at this side. It takes some time to get over here. Out. So look where it ran out. So pick it back. Start again. It all takes time.
I mean, that's yes.
Yeah, on the loom to stop it. Yeah. Yeah. It's a good thing that was after the invention of the power loom. That was probably the single most important invention afterwards. In fact, it was the most single important. I mean, and all of them grab them because it meant that the weaver could leave this
and it stopped
all on to an end and it would stop anything going off.
Yeah.
If it did turn at the first one, left, the loom would know and it would just carry on. Well, it gets to the point because it's not weaving anything, these threads end up down here and it puts too much strain on it. It gets a bit too slack, stuff will catch, break those out. But could also catch the side, damages the reed, and it's a big job then. So that was, again, so simple,
it's unbelievable.
Low, that's funny, Warren. It was, once that was developed, that was it then, one, two, but not multiple ways. Sorry to hurt you all about, but at the book today was only myself on. I didn't want anybody to miss anything. For those of you that haven't seen the weaving in the weaving shed, once I've done this, I'll go back in there and run that for a few minutes before we knock the engine off for this first session. Turret Evelyn loom, this, apart from the two large looms, the Sulzer and the Sour over there, this would be our latest acquisition year-wise. The design of the loom dates from about 1955, British Northrop, made in Blackburn. This particular model was built with think between 59, well, we know it's between 59 and 63. More of a slant towards 1963 because of some of the electrical panels that are on it. Where a guy from British North Rock came and had a look at it. Fortunately, we couldn't say exactly because some kind person has removed the brass nameplate that has got the serial number on it. So we can't exact. We think around about between 10 and towards 63. So once you get it going, you've only come forward and walk it.
Things the boiler, and it's got two furnaces.
Two furnaces.
And they're just the actual fire itself.
Whoa! Interesting. And so is this the temperature, is the gauge working now?
Yeah, that's the pressure inside the boiler.
Oh, that's okay.
The steam pressure. The temperature is about 2000.